Hey there! In this video we are going to show you how to play Café, a game where each player controls a company to produce, process and deliver coffee. It can be played by 1 to 4 players in about half an hour by players with at least 10 years old. We will show you how to set up the game, including what is different depending on the player count. Each player is dealt a company card, as well as the corresponding initial card, which can be identified by the company logo on their backs. In addition, the last person drinking coffee receives the master token. Colored cubes in the supply are coffee beans, each color representing a different origin. Each player is given one of each type to place under the corresponding bean color on the company card. That space will be therefore mentioned as the warehouse. There is a multiplier 5 space used as a way of resource management. Having a single cube on that space is the same as having 5 cubes of the same color on the warehouse. You can exchange 5 per one and vice versa at any point of the game. Another feature is the action point track. To track their actions, each player receives a big white cube looking a lot like a sugar cube. Player actions are measured by the number of visible cups in the playing area, so when the game starts, all players have one action point. The last aspect of the setup is the only that depends on the playing count. With 4 players, all 48 plan cards are in play. With 3 players, the 8 cards marked with a star in the back are removed to the box. With 2 players, 8 random cards are removed plus the cards with a star. In a solo game, 16 cards are removed plus the cards with a star. After removing the unnecessary cards, the remaining are shuffled and placed within all players' reach. In the beginning of each round, 3 cards are drawn face up from the deck by the player holding the master token. Then, the player on the left of the master chooses a card. Another card is drawn to replace it before the next player clockwise chooses. Once all players have chosen a card, including the master, the 2 remaining are discarded. The game is played during 8 rounds, and the deck of playing cards will be empty by then at any player count. 8 is also the highest number of action points that a player can use in a turn, being 1 the minimum. 0 is only there so the players can decrease their action points by the time they use them. Action points don't accumulate between rounds. As stated before, actions are measured by the number of visible cups in the playing area. By taking cards with coffee cups, you can increase the number of actions per turn. However, every time you take a card with a cup, you have to pay a coffee bean from the warehouse. All other cards without coffee cups are always free to take. If you have 2 visible ships in your playing area, you don't have to pay for any card, including the ones with coffee cups. After paying the corresponding cost, each player places the new card in the playing area. There are some details to consider when placing a card into your playing area, also ensuring you always have space around your cards to place new ones. A card must always be placed above one or more cards, it can never be placed below any other. You can rotate a card in any direction before placing it, and you must always cover a minimum of 2 and a maximum of 4 squares from previous cards. You will notice that there are smaller and larger coffee shops. A larger coffee shop occupies 2 squares, so covering a larger coffee shop counts as covering 2 squares as well. If during a placing action one or more coffee beans are covered by a card, they are discarded and returned to the general supply. On a side note, joining similar icons in the same cluster may be a smart move. You take great advantage of it, as we will show you right away. After placing the new card in their playing area, players use all their action points for the round, performing an action per each. Then, the master token is passed to the next player clockwise. There are 4 possible actions, also the 4 sequential stages that the coffee bean passes by. Action A is to produce, action B is to dry, action C is to roast, and action D is to deliver. There is more to those actions that it may seem at first sight, but let's begin with the basics and then advance for the specifics. If you choose to produce, you take 1 bean of the matching color from the supply and add it to the corresponding A square. If you choose to dry, you take all the beans from the desired color in A squares and join them in the same corresponding B square. If you choose to roast, you take all the beans from the desired color in B squares and join them in the same corresponding C square. If you choose to deliver, you take the beans of all colors from all the C squares and place them into your coffee shops, obviously meeting the specifier requirements. Remaining coffee beans as a result of this action are placed in your warehouse. With the exception for coffee shops, no other square can hold coffee beans from different colors at the same time. As stated before, joining similar actions in the same cluster may be a smart move. Let's take the production action as the first example. If you have a group of production squares orthogonally adjacent to each other, you can use a single action point to produce coffee beans in all of them. If they were apart, you would have to use an action point to produce each one individually. Each production square can only hold one coffee bean at a time, so if it has a coffee bean already, it will not produce again until it's empty. The same rule for adjacency applies to the drying action. If you have a group, you can use a single action point and each square can dry coffee beans of a unique color. If they were apart, you would have to use an action point to dry on each square individually. Each dry square can only hold one color at a time. As you are probably guessing, the same is valid for the roasting action. If you have a group, you can use a single action point and each square can roast coffee beans of a unique color. If they were apart, you would have to use an action point to roast on each square individually. Each roast square can only hold one color at a time. For the delivery action, all coffee shops and the warehouse are considered as being a part of a distribution network, so they act as they were all adjacent because the network can reach them. You can take all the beans from all the C squares at the same time with only one action point. If at any moment part of the totality of a coffee shop is covered by cards, it is no longer available for distribution and it will no longer earn you potential victory points. As stated before, when delivering, you can place coffee beans both into the coffee shops and into the warehouse. Each coffee shop has an indication for types and amount of coffee beans that it can take. If you meet all the requirements for their coffee shop by the end of the game, you receive the points indicated. Otherwise, coffee beans in there won't grant you any points. In addition, you will score points for the two sets with less coffee beans you have in your warehouse. The color with less coffee beans scores you 2 points each. The next color with less coffee beans scores you only 1 point each. On each case, if you have no cubes of a specific color, that will score you 0 points. And that is all you need to know to be able to play Café. On the rulebook, you can find tiebreakers and an advanced variant. For more information on this game, you can go to BoardGameGeek or the official channels of the game publisher. The links are in the video description below, as well as the game overview details. If any rule wasn't clear, or is there anything you want to tell us regarding this video, just let us know in the comments. Until then, stay connected and be safe. See you soon!